I mean, look, we know you can buy some of that stuff in bulk, and you might get ahead of your fines there a little bit.
You can hit the Costco.
$25. Yeah, a case of 24 cans, and you're almost there.
Absolutely, and you're giving back to an amazing cause. This can be kind of a slow time for the food bank because, you know, you're coming right off of the holidays.
Yeah.
So it's just a perfect way for us to team up. Last year, we got more than 8,100 food items that we were able to give them. That feeds about 6,700 Marylanders. So it's just this great partnership. It's a great way to give back.
Really is. Look, food items that people can donate. We mentioned canned food, but that can get kind of heavy if you have a lot of fines. What else can people bring?
Exactly. Well, you can go on our website, prattlibrary.org, and we have a full list of all of the stuff that they're really looking for. A lot of times they're looking for healthy food options, mm-hmm. so it can be the vegetables, the canned vegetables, the canned proteins, but it can also be granola bars, you know, the boxed mac and cheese, mm-hmm. that type of stuff. So we have the full list of what they're looking for that you can bring, and it might be stuff that you already have sitting in your in your kitchen. It just has to be obviously not expired, and we don't accept glass containers because they're just a little hard for us to transport.
Avoid the glass.
Yes, please avoid the glass containers.
All right. Also at the library, I know there's some other exciting changes going on. I think you have kind of a big announcement this week.
Yes, we had a really big announcement this week that we're excited about, that we have expanded the hours of the libraries across the entire system. It's more than 30% expansion of library hours. It's really historic for us. So it means that your library, you'll always know when your library is open. We'll have extended evening hours. We're going to have a more universal schedule. Mm-hmm. So prior to this, you know, maybe the Canton branch opened at noon and Southeast Anchor opened at 10. Now, 6 days a week, all of your neighborhood libraries will open at 10 a.m. On Mondays and Thursdays, a lot of the neighborhood branches will be open 10 to 8, so you get some extra evening hours. Southeast Anchor and our Pennsylvania Avenue branches will now be the hubs of the east and the west sides of the city, and they'll have 4 days, Monday through Thursday, they'll be open 10 to 8, and then 10 to 5 on other days, and then they'll just be closed on Sundays. Our central library is going to 7 days a week. So it's huge, and it's not even just in the libraries. Our mobile units are doubling the amount of time that they'll be spending on the roads. So our book buggy that goes to daycare centers and WIC centers to help our most vulnerable children will be on the road 5 days a week now. Prior to this, they were on the road about 2 or 3 days a week.
So many things going on, and a great expansion there, Meg.
Always.
One last thing, I mean, just for people who maybe haven't been or haven't been in a long time, when they walk in, I mean, people think the classic book, but there's so much more than just picking up a book at the library, right?
It is like a recreation center, a community center. It really is a neighborhood hub. We have free computer classes, free job training. We have free fitness classes if you're trying to, you know, whittle the waistline for that. We do. Okay. I was in a jammer size class at our Cherry Hill location the other day. And the important thing is, like, 99.9% of our programs are all free. So when you come in, you just sign up and you walk in. We have free yoga classes. I mean, it's amazing. You just go on our website and take a look at what we have to offer. I think you'll really be surprised.
We will do that. Exercise our mind and our body, and more hours to do it now.
Mm-hmm.
Megan McCorkle, thank you so much for coming in, telling us about everything going on at Enoch Pratt Free Library. Stay with us. We'll be back with more Midday Maryland right after this.